class while I am working with your fellow classmates with I'm working with them on writing. I would like for you to go ahead, start painting your shoe. This is a shoe that's based on a very iconic shoe called the Converse Chuck Taylor All-Stars. And every generation has their own nickname for them. In my day, they were Chucks. Some people called them All-Stars. People call them All-Stars nowadays too. They have a distinctive red star here in the in that circle. And what I like about these shoes is how they, man, they used to be so, when I had these canvas shoes, my feet used to stay pretty cool because I would play basketball at recess. And when I was playing basketball, sometimes my feet would get so hot in my leather shoes that, we would get back to the classroom and I would loosen the laces right here. I would loosen those laces and take them off and just to cool my feet down. Cause we had a, like Ocean View, we had an outdoor blacktop playground surface and the heat would be absorbed by that material, the blacktop asphalt material. And, the heat would go right through the soles of my shoe and into my, through my socks into my feet. So you get back to my our classroom, you know, it'd be like fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade, seventh grade. I was playing basketball all through middle school even. And we go back to class and there I was taking my shoes off and whew, some days my feet really stunk. So I had to be careful that people weren't looking around when I had my shoes off because I didn't want to be stinking up the room. Oh, and the reason I chose blue, a couple reasons. It is probably my favorite overall color. If I had just one color, someone said, what's your favorite color? This is the color I would choose. It reminds me, I like it with watercolor especially because the water in Hawaii, Oahu especially, by where I spent a lot of time as a kid, the blue in the water changed colors depending on the time of day, depending on the light. So I would, or I still have a very nice and fond association with blue, especially light color blue that changes colors a bit. So that's why I chose this. You don't have to go all blue. I think I might do something interesting with the laces. I haven't yet decided, but I was pretty sure as soon as I saw this and I decided to paint to show you a sample for Friday, I had a good feeling it'd be blue. So students in the past have done colors like designs. So if you choose to do a design on your shoe and then paint in the design, that might be cool too. Let's go ahead and paint the whole thing. I might do red laces. Let's see how I feel about that. And as you know, as I'm talking to you and painting here, I'm reminded of is it Bob Ross? There's a famous artist. He was a TV artist, so he would get on the television and he would, you know, just do green. And he would talk as he painted. And as a kid, I found it very soothing to watch someone paint and to see them or to hear their voice because he had a very soothing voice. Hopefully my voice is soothing. I don't know if I want brown in the background or what, but you know, I'm gonna let it sit for a little while. Speaking of brown, I have a pair of boots and I actually drew the boot here. I don't have them anymore, but they were a treasured pair. So if you wanna paint the sneaker, you may. If you wanna paint this, you can. And when this dries, I might actually go and paint this also. So backgrounds, I think what I'll do while I'm waiting for this to dry is I'm gonna color the background. Or no, not color the background. I'm going to do a pattern in the back. Remember how I said I had fond memories of Hawaii? So I'm going to do a wave design here. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So some of you are going to do designs on your shoe. And if you do, that's awesome. And if you would rather do designs in the background, or both, if you want to do designs in the background and on the shoe, that's A-okay too. I like wavy designs. Computer wants to go to sleep. So I like wavy designs because like I said, Hawaii waves and the ocean waves are a big part of life. But also, it's just something very appealing about these lines to me. Makes me feel calm. When I see straight lines or harsh lines intersecting, I get a kind of an unpleasant feeling. But when I see wavy lines like this, something about it is a soothing feeling. So I figure since I did blue there, what if I throw in some brighter colors in the back just to mix it up? I'll do maybe orange here. So I hope you had a good week. I know a couple days there for a while, the air was really yucky. And even in the classroom here, I could smell smoke in the classroom. And it was not pleasant. So I don't know if you had that experience in your house, or, you know, if you stand. Sometimes if I'm by an open window or a door that has a gap in it, I can smell the smoke coming through that gap. That's not a good feeling to me. So I try to get away from that gap if I can. And get some fresh air. I'm going to alternate and go warm color, cool color, warm color, cool color. So the warm colors, I could leave that up there. So the warm colors are here, red, orange, yellow. Those are considered warm. And the cooler colors are the ones next to that. Green, blue, purple for sure. Brown, I would put brown with warm. But I guess it kind of depends. It depends on how they've mixed the brown. But for me, I think when you mix a brown paint, there's red is a big part of the base color. So, yeah, that's what I've got so far. So we've got yellow, orange, yellow. I think I'll skip one again and go red. So you notice I'm sticking to all my warm colors for now. It came out pink. And these are, I hope you're enjoying these watercolor paints. We got these during the summer. Ordered them in the beginning of the year. Actually, we ordered them late. Well, whenever we ordered them, they arrived. And I like them because you get to keep yours with you. You know, in the classroom, one of the most challenging parts of the classroom is sharing, and some people being possessive. I know, you know, some people would see this and go, "I don't want to use this. Look at that mess." So instead, they would go back and they would throw it in the paint tray and try to get the neatest one. And meanwhile, everybody else is doing the same thing. And instead of doing art, you know, there's bickering about who's got the prettiest paint tray. It's not really about the prettiest paint tray, in my opinion. So I have options now. I could go here, maybe flip it. So if this was yellow and then a red. Ah, yeah. I like that. Since I just did red, I'll do red again. So red, yellow, orange, yellow, red. Do that right? Yellow here, nothing red. I'm going for it. One of the big lessons of Bob Ross as a painter was accidents are no big deal. And I realized when I started doing mistakes are the best teachers, and Bob Ross was one of my first teachers. I never met the man, but he was an art teacher, and right now I'm carrying on with his lessons and the spirit of what he did. Talking to viewers he can't see, but he knows are out there, and leaving a message for the leaving a message for people who may see this soon, may see this tomorrow, and some people might see it a long time from now. Some people will never see it. Oh, I make a mistake? I might have made a mistake. Let's see. Orange. Orange, nothing. And this is going to be yellow. I think what I need to solve my problem here, I think I just continue this line whoop, like that. And then after red, I'll do the orange again. So I have a little snip. Another nice lesson that I learned in art is try to have things go beyond the edge of the page. And if you do that, you make the page, it seems like the page goes, it's just a snip of a bigger art, piece of art. You know, so if the orange, like if I didn't do this, and if I just painted to the edge of the page, you might not have the sense that this is bigger. If you, sometimes when you stay in the frame, it seems like the piece of paper is small. But when I do this, when I go to the edge like this, it seems like the edge of the page is just happens to be trimmed off. And maybe this was once upon a time, people who never see this video, but they see this. Once upon a time, maybe this was a larger painting that was trimmed on a paper cutter. So what did I do? Yep, I think I'm good. All I need now is the yellow. And then, blurg. And water, spilling water on my watercolor. Yeah, could be worse. What's next? Yellow, I said. So, the weekend is coming up, and I like the weekend. I like to be able to rest a little bit. I sleep in. I'm curious what you do on the weekends, if you do the same thing. If you wake up at the same time, or if you wake up earlier and get, I don't know if getting up and watching cartoons on a Saturday is still something kids do, but a lot of kids in my generation, that was a thing. You would, you know, maybe stay up about the same night on a Friday. Maybe your family lets you stay up a little later. And then the next day, Saturday, whew, man, I'd wake up. I think my sister and I would both wake up and hopefully agree on a cartoon to watch and eat some cereal. Eat some cereal and watch Saturday morning cartoons, including Transformers, which ties into that writing activity I told you about. And I'm just gonna go green. What the heck? It's like I didn't make that very damp because it's coming out pretty dark. So that was a lot of fun. Saturday morning cartoons. And then now with the internet and cable, I don't know if people even, you all have cable, but with all these streaming services, you know, you want to watch Transformers and it's 1983, you got to wake up at Saturday or, you know, get home at 3 o'clock to watch Transformers. Or it's another one we liked, He-Man and She-Ra. That was another one we liked. There's only one time to see it. And then now, you want to see it, you could say, hey Siri, can I watch Transformers?
Which one? Here are some options.
Yeah, see?
Transformers Dark of the Moon. Transformers Cyberverse.
That's the one.
Transformers Revenge.
Transformers 1984. That's when
you'll need to unlock your iPhone first.
Alright, it's not worth that. But that was just trying to make a point about how, you know, you can watch any kind of show from any era. You can watch shows that my parents used to watch, you know, cartoons from that era. You can watch cartoons that just came out, you know, a week ago. Amazing the number of options we all have now. Of course, as much fun as that is, what I'm doing right now, I wouldn't trade. You know, I wouldn't I wouldn't say, hey, Kevin, you can either, like right now, I could put this away and can get on my device here and start watching someone else's entertainment, or I can, I already did blue. Blue is in the shoe. But I think this is purple. Purple, brown. Purple, brown. Brown, purple, purple. Purple, brown, purple, brown. Purple, brown, purple, brown. I'm doing that. Purple. Yeah. So that's one of the reasons I'm doing this activity, and instead of just showing you a little bit and actually painting the whole thing, is that maybe you could put this on and you paint while watching me paint. Miss Mary Ernst, who is a colleague of mine and a wonderful artist in her own right, she does these sort of art videos where she does art. She talks to the camera and does an art project, and those are really impressive projects too. Some of them are you can really challenge yourself and really make it look nice. Take your time, of course. Be willing to make mistakes like I did there with the water spilling all over the stuff. So I said purple, brown. Purple, brown, purple. Purple, brown, purple. And I think I once had a pair of purple Converse All-Stars. Now that I think about it. And that's one thing I'm noticing as I do this. You know, when I watch, sometimes when I watch TV shows, my mind doesn't wander. And I don't start, like, see how this flow is happening? Like, when I am painting or dabbling with music on the iPad there, my mind wanders to other things. And I like that. Because if I'm doing homework or I'm teaching or doing things like that, my brain is locked into one thing. Sometimes it's nice to have your mind wander into the purple Converse. I definitely had a pair of dark blue Converse, and then I had a pair of black Converse. Purple, either I had it or someone I know had it, but definitely have seen it before. And not like seen it, oh look, there's somebody wearing purple Converse, but actually seen it frequently. So I'm just about done here. I hope you enjoyed listening and watching paint. I think sometimes it's soothing to watch somebody do art. In addition to Bob Ross, there's actually a show, and I've been meaning to look this up. It was a show on TV, and someone would tell a story, and the other person would be drawing the story. And for some reason there was a story about a fox and a dog, or a fox, and the reason the fox stood out was there was the fox, the person drew the fox, and either the fox was orange or the background paper was orange, and then the artist was doing drawings on this orange paper and using colored pastels, and it was so incredible. For me, when I was younger, and still now, when I watch, if you ever watch calligraphy videos, highly recommend calligraphy videos. You watch calligraphy videos and people making lettering, it just seems like it comes out of nowhere. And I don't know, that seems magical to me. Yeah, I like how that came out. All right, so this is a smudge of water. You can do that if you want. Make mistakes and be okay with it. Remember the one thing, I think I told you earlier, always make sure you put your name and number in your work, and I forgot to do that here. And I decided I don't want red laces. I think I'm going to go with black. I used to have a thing about when I was younger, I liked breakdancing, hip hop music and breakdancing and graffiti art. So I really liked these fat laces. So I'm going to drop some black. I'm not going to do any fancy checkerboard or anything. That's a bit too much for this activity. You do whatever you want. If you want to do really intricate, detailed designs, that's fine too. If I could do gray. What that look like? It's too dark. Yeah, that's better. I'm feeling like making this gray. And then maybe like a... Maybe I'm overdoing it. Maybe I just should have stopped and left it white, but I don't know. Sort of in it now. That's the thing. Once you get to a point, you know, you made a decision to do something, you kind of just have to go with it. Yeah, and I think, now that I see it, I think I like it. Because I think what happens is, by putting the gray in here, it makes it look more like a real shoe. Whoa, that's pretty dark. Ah, I did not think it was going to be that dark. Yikes. Can I save it? Can I get some of this dark, dark black paint out of here? Yeah, I'm lightening it up. Well, stay calm. Never make mistakes. You know, it could be out in real life, like, you know, your shopping cart runs away from you and is about to hit a car. Just, you know, look both ways. Make sure there's no cars coming. Try to go retrieve it. And I think I told you there was a red star. See how my star drawing... comes out. And then this is going to be it. This is going to be, Bob Ross had this thing about he would find a spot, he'd get to like the last tree, and then he would do that last tree and say, yep, that's it, I'm done. I'm almost done. I want to do a hint. I want to do a hint of the, what is it? It's like the logo, right? But I'm not going to try and write it. I'm just going to do the burp. All right. Yeah, I think I've got it, folks. I am feeling good about this. All right. Do whatever makes you happy. Whatever joy you can find. Let's try and darken some of this up again. This is what some people call this blending. And that's kind of what I'm doing. The trick, hopefully you notice that the trick, part of the trick to this is not to use too much water. If you use too much water, the paper absorbs it the way a sponge absorbs water. And then it bends, so this whole paper is kind of bending. So anyway, watercolor. So that's watercolor, and this is good paper. Sometimes watercolor is a good thing to use, but if you, it's a good thing to use on, this is okay paper, this is great paper. There's even something better than this. It's like extraordinary paper. It's called watercolor paper. Ooh, watercolor paper is incredible. Maybe I'll get some watercolor paper and that'll be sent home in future supply pickups. All right, I could probably keep talking and painting for another, whatever this was, 15 minutes longer. But I should probably wrap this up, go home, and stop being Mr. Corcoran for just a little bit. Just be Kevin, and come back and be Mr. Corcoran again tomorrow. All right. Hope you enjoyed that. Until next time, aloha and au revoir.